Je serai donc votre MC pour la conférence Together Ensemble. Et je vous parle d'Edmonton, Alberta, qui est situé sur le Crété Territoire 6. Terre traditionnelle des Premières Nations et des Métis. In fact, Treaty 6 is a traditional gathering place for diverse indigenous people, including the Cree, the Blackfoot, the Nakota, the Métis, the Sioux, the Iroquois, Dene, Ojibwe, Soto, Anishinaabe, and many other whose histories, languages, and cultures continue to influence our vibrant communities. Together Ensemble is hosted through partnership between Waterloo Global Science Initiative, the Sustainable Development Goals, Sustainable Development Solution Network, and University of Laval. It's also funded in part by the Government of Canada Sustainable Development Goals Funding Program with additional support from Alberta Global Council for Global Cooperation. Alliance 2030 and Premier Institute for Theoretical Physics and the University of Waterloo. L'équipe organisatrice de l'événement d'aujourd'hui dirige les opérations depuis Waterloo en Ontario, qui est situé sur le Haldimand Track, territoire qui a été promis au Dinoshine, des Six Nations de la Grande Rivière, et se trouve aussi dans le territoire des peuples Neuk, Anishinaabe et Haudenosaunee. Au fur et à mesure que l'on participe tous à la conférence à Together Ensemble, nous vous invitons vraiment à faire une rétrospective sur l'endroit où vos pieds sont posés, à explorer les personnes qui partagent ce territoire avec vous, son histoire coloniale et les différentes innovations transformatrices qui peuvent être réalisées au cours de la prochaine décennie. To learn more about Indigenous land, you may want to visit Native-Land, a project that helps Canadians learn more about Indigenous people around the world. If you've never been to a Together conference before, you should know that the UN Sustainable Development Goals is for everyone. If there's a way that we can help you have a positive, better, and engaging experience throughout the conference, please reach out on the live chat below, and one of the organizers will be able to assist you. Mon rôle à Together Ensemble est de vous guider à travers cette conférence électronique qui était initialement prévue avec un rassemblement en personne à l'Université de Laval au Québec. Bien sûr, déplacer un événement comme celui-ci d'une telle grandeur pose beaucoup de défis intéressants, et nous vous demandons d'être patients avec nous au fur et à mesure que l'on résout ces problèmes. Nous essaierons de résoudre autant de problèmes que possible dans la mesure de nos capacités. Let me walk you all through a few features of our Zoom conferences. Currently, you're on mute. For any of the plenaries, viewing parties, or breakouts, you'll be on mute as well, but have access to the Q&A and live chat functions. These sessions are recorded. Just so you know, the live chat is moderated for respectful dialogue. Organizers can be identified by the word organizers in the display name on Zoom. And we ask that you use your real name and not a nickname that you've used on a Zoom chat with your friends or anything of the sort. Together Ensemble has a code of conduct, which we've just linked to in the chat. And if you experience an issue or notice that someone else is being harassed or have any other concerns throughout the conference, please contact a member of the Together Ensemble organizing team immediately, as soon as possible. Organizers can also be reached via email at info.togetherensemble@gmail.com. And please make your subject line urgent. Urgent code of conduct. Si vous êtes victime de harcèlement ou remarquez que quelqu'un d'autre est harcelé ou avez d'autres préoccupations, s'il vous plaît, veuillez contacter immédiatement un membre de l'équipe organisatrice de Together Ensemble. Les organisateurs peuvent être identifiés par le mot organizer dans le nom d'affichage sur Zoom. Les organisateurs peuvent également être contacté à travers email à info.togetherensemble@gmail.com. Et s'il vous plaît, veuillez indiquer sur votre ligne de sujet urgent 2 points code de conduite. There's an alternate audio track where you can access an interpreted version of the main language in each session. Most of the content will be available both in French and English. You can toggle between languages in bilingual session as well if you want to. You may also want to select mute original audio if you only want to listen to the interpreter in either English or French. They are going to be rapporteurs in each session. Their job is going to be document the insights and reflect them back to you in the plenary sessions. The notes will be compiled after the event and released as a report. The lead rapporteur is Jake Berkowitz, and you'll meet him later today. If you choose to go to a Coffee Connection, you will have an opportunity to connect in small groups with others to review the presentation from previous block. Once you arrive, you will randomly be sorted into small breakout groups. We can't guarantee that you will end up in a conversation group if you're late arriving. So please make sure you get to these Coffee Connections early. And just so you know, Coffee Connections are not recorded. You also have a lot of choices. There's going to be a lot of choices in programming. So don't worry about missing out a session. You'll be able to catch up on other sessions. When they are posted to Together on Psalm's YouTube channel, we'll try to post them as quickly as possible. At the end of each day, you'll receive a daily digest newsletter from our partners at Future Good. If you miss sessions, you can catch up quickly and not miss a bit. So these are going to be great for anyone that really wants to just kind of like go back to the materials that we done during the sessions, or also for those that missed it and just want to make sure that they are up to date. Our goal is to make the programming easy for you to access. So all the links are in the schedule. You should be able to access that by now. You can move from room to room during each programming block. Please don't share the links with anyone else. Everyone who has registered for the event has access to the same schedule. If something goes wrong during one of the sessions, the presenter's connection drops or the connection is really bad, we try to arrange a follow-up recording and make the session available after the event. If we can solve the problem quickly, we'll direct you to another session. The spirit of Together Ensemble is one of cooperation and mutual respect. The commitment to leave no one behind has been described by UN Deputy Secretary General Jan Han Eyasso as the underlying moral code of Agenda 2030. And we are striving to make this motto a foundational part of this event. We know that our approach is imperfect, and we welcome any constructive suggestions and guidance for future events or for future sessions as well. As you engage in conversations, please remember that we come from different regions of Canada, have different religious and ethnic backgrounds, and speak different languages, our mother tongue. Sometimes disagreement is based on a misunderstanding of another person's actual point of view. So always ask for clarification first, and at all times we recommend people to be tough on issues and problems, but soft on people. It's a really hard time for everyone. We're in isolation, so we're doing this conference online, so you know, be kind to each other, and we really want to make sure that each one of you feels welcome and respected and able to participate fully and value throughout the conference. So what are we here to achieve together? What are we here to achieve together today and tomorrow as well? We are here to build on the good work begun by the Alberta Council for Global Cooperation back in 2017 and 2018, which were the first together conferences, and the aim to promote work that is happening across the country, new opportunities for us to do collective impact, mobilization of good practices, effective research and policy work, and new partnerships, innovation, and pathways for progress on the SDGs. Nous espérons que vous ferez de nouvelles relations, planterez de nouvelles graines pour de nouvelles collaborations et que vous prendrez des engagements et des actions en vue de l'agenda 2030. Nous avons une longue journée de programmation devant nous et quelques invités importants attendent dans les coulisses pour faire un discours d'ouverture. S'il vous plaît, veuillez vous joindre à moi pour souhaiter la bienvenue à l'honorable Ahmed Hussein, ministre de la Famille, des Enfants et du Développement Social et député de York Southwestern en Ontario.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for having me here today. I appreciate the opportunity to be at this conference. Bonjour tout le monde. I want to thank Together Ensemble for bringing together Canada's key stakeholders on the Sustainable Development Goals from the private sector, academia, government, and civil society. I know the work that you do to push forward the 17 Sustainable Development Goals in Canada. The 2030 Agenda, as we know, is a call to action and a commitment to leave no one behind. And at its core are the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. These goals recognize that ending poverty must go hand in hand with policies that improve health and education, reduce inequality, and spur economic growth, all the while tackling climate change and protecting and preserving our environment. Now more than ever, the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development provides our world with a common framework to tackle our most pressing challenges. And the Sustainable Development Goals are a shared responsibility. And I'm proud to say that to support Canadian organizations helping to advance SDG action in Canada, I'm pleased to announce on behalf of the Government of Canada, $4.3 million today to go to 47 organizations across the country to push forward on the Sustainable Development Goals. By supporting these projects, the SDG funding program will raise awareness of the SDGs in Canada, develop new partnerships, improve knowledge on emerging sustainable development issues, implement innovative approaches that advance several SDGs, and support the important work of reconciliation with Indigenous peoples. Thank you so much for having me today. Merci beaucoup.
Bonjour, chers amis. C'est avec plaisir que je vous adresse quelques mots au nom du gouvernement du Québec dans le cadre de cet événement d'importance portant sur les objectifs de développement durable des Nations unies. Les circonstances exceptionnelles que nous vivons tous depuis quelques mois nous démontrent à quel point il est important que nous travaillions tous ensemble à la mise en place de ces objectifs. Plus que jamais, nous prenons conscience des interrelations extrêmement étroites entre les enjeux sanitaires, environnementaux, alimentaires et sociaux et de la nécessité de coopérer pour bâtir un monde plus durable. Le gouvernement du Québec travaille en ce sens. Nous préparons la prochaine stratégie gouvernementale de développement durable pour la période 2021-2026. Son objectif est d'aligner la gestion des ministères et organismes sur les principes de la Loi sur le développement durable du Québec. Nous dévoilerons aussi dans les mois à venir notre nouveau plan pour une économie verte. Ce sont deux politiques qui donneront un nouveau souffle à nos efforts en la matière. Notre engagement vers le développement durable se répercute aussi à l'international. À titre d'État fédéré, le Québec participe activement aux travaux de différentes organisations internationales responsables de la mise en œuvre de certains objectifs de développement durable, dont l'UNESCO, l'OMS et la FAO. Nous suivons de près, et ce depuis plusieurs années, les travaux des conventions onusiennes sur la diversité biologique et sur le climat. Depuis, nous avons mis en œuvre plusieurs actions de solidarité et de coopération internationale qui permettent de contribuer à la réalisation des objectifs de développement durable dans certains pays en développement. L'atteinte de ces objectifs repose notamment sur l'implication de plusieurs acteurs réunis aujourd'hui. Nos intentions en matière de développement durable ne peuvent être que renforcées dans ce contexte de pandémie. La protection de l'environnement et la lutte contre les changements climatiques seront au centre de la relance. Ce nouveau contexte nous encourage à favoriser l'économie locale éco-responsable et circulaire, de même que le télétravail, à développer l'autonomie alimentaire et accélérer les projets de transport structurants. Nous voulons créer de la richesse en exploitant au maximum notre hydroélectricité, une énergie propre qui fait notre fierté. Nous allons électrifier davantage nos transports, nos entreprises, nos bâtiments, tout en réussissant notre transition énergétique. Et nous allons nous assurer que les atouts du Québec puissent contribuer à la résilience et à la prospérité durable de l'ensemble de la planète. La santé étant l'un des éléments clés du développement durable, la pandémie que nous vivons influencera pendant longtemps les orientations de développement que nos sociétés prendront. Nous devons continuer de travailler au développement durable de nos sociétés. En ce sens, le travail que vous ferez durant ce congrès est primordial et je vous en remercie. Bon congrès.
Bonjour à tous et à toutes. Hi everyone. Kwe. J'aurais vraiment aimé vous recevoir aujourd'hui à l'Université Laval dans notre belle ville de Québec. Mais distanciation physique oblige, je vous souhaite la bienvenue virtuellement, mais tout aussi chaleureusement, à la conférence Together Ensemble 2020. Nous sommes réunis parce que nous avons un objectif commun, une planète en santé et des humains en santé. Aujourd'hui, plus que jamais, nous comprenons qu'il y a une interrelation entre les deux. Cette pandémie que nous vivons nous force à prendre nos distances pour protéger les personnes âgées et les gens à la santé fragile. C'est ça la santé durable et le développement durable. Protéger les populations vulnérables en premier pour notre bien collectif. Pour arriver à cette santé collective et planétaire, nous vous proposons de partager nos savoirs et nous proposons d'être ambitieux dans nos actions. Et la conférence d'aujourd'hui nous permet de faire un pas dans ce sens parce qu'elle est gratuite et virtuelle et elle permet de diffuser à large échelle les savoirs et les bonnes pratiques. Alors, je vous remercie d'être nombreux à y participer, j'en suis ravie. Je dois dire aussi que cette conférence nous permet de prendre un pas de recul pour réfléchir à d'autres crises potentielles, éventuellement les prévenir, des crises écologiques, socio-économiques ou migratoires. À l'Université Laval, comme dans d'autres universités, nous déployons de grands efforts afin d'être un modèle qui inspire notre communauté. Notre campus, depuis 5 ans, est carbone neutre, car nous réduisons nos gaz à effet de serre à la source et nous compensons nos autres émissions. Et nos professeurs, nos étudiants et étudiantes ont à cœur de trouver des solutions qui sont innovantes et qui nous permettent de lutter contre les changements climatiques. Comme hôte du Sommet international étudiant pour le climat en 2021, nous offrirons un espace de discussion pour que les jeunes de partout dans le monde puissent réfléchir à l'action et préparer des plans d'action. Alors, merci aux organisateurs et partenaires de Together Ensemble, nommément de Sustainable Development Solutions Network Canada, de Waterloo Global Science Initiative, et l'Institut Hydro-Québec en environnement, développement et société. Alors, to all of you, I wish you a conference filled with hope and inclusive solutions. Je vous souhaite à vous tous et toutes une très bonne conférence.
Good morning, everyone. It is my pleasure to bring greetings on behalf of the Canadian chapter of the Sustainable Development Solutions Network, as well as the University of Waterloo, which co-hosts this network with our nonprofit partner, the Waterloo Global Science Initiative. Who could have imagined that the decade for action on the SDGs, a decade to end poverty, rescue the planet, and build a peaceful world, would have begun with a global pandemic, followed by what is expected to be a prolonged period of economic recession, or worse? So there are challenges. But the caliber of people gathered here today is up to these challenges, up to the challenge of confronting today's realities while putting in place the building blocks of a brighter future. And we know this road to recovery, to resilience, and to readiness begins with dialogue, with listening and sharing in ways that lead to rigorous analysis, careful discernment, and inspirational action. And that, of course, is why we're gathered here. As an academic dean, I understand the critical role that education and post-secondary institutions can play in achieving the SDGs. We have the privilege of working with talented, entrepreneurial, and hopeful students who are committed to both understanding and action, to putting their knowledge to work in finding solutions to the SDGs. Across Canada and the world, sustainability concepts are increasingly embedded in curricula in arts, business, engineering, health, and the natural and social sciences. The Canadian chapter of the Sustainable Development Solutions Network now comprises 38 institutional members, whole universities, colleges, faculties, institutes, and think tanks. As part of the global network, we join 1,100 other members in working through how to achieve the 17 SDGs in a post-COVID world. These networks are committed to supporting the implementation of the SDGs at local, national, and global scales by translating the latest expertise in sustainable development into action, by educating and mobilizing our youth, by transforming our own campuses, and by partnering with others. Like all of you, SDSN is committed to building back better. We look forward to charting a path for doing just that with all of you. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. And thanks very much for having us here today to talk to you about the UN Sustainable Development Goals at the Office of the Auditor General of Canada. My name is Kimberly Leach, and I'm a principal in the office. I've been working on these issues for many years. And I'm joined today by Elsa Da Costa, who's a director in the office and working on our current audit on sustainable development goals. So we're very pleased to be here with you today. We have about 5 minutes, so I'm going to go quite quickly, but I'm going to talk to you about three things. One is just briefly who we are and what we do. I want to talk to you about how we've integrated the Sustainable Development Goals into our federal audits. And then I'm going to talk to you about the audits that we have done and are currently doing. So with that then, we'll move on to the next slide. And the Commissioner of the Environment and Sustainable Development within the Office of the Auditor General is a fairly unique entity. Other countries do have commissioners. But ours is the only one that we're aware of that is within the Auditor General, the Auditor General's office. So we have a special view, we like to think, of accountability. And this position was established in 1995, and we report directly to Parliament, usually twice a year, in the spring and the fall. And our Act requires us to do three things. Firstly, we monitor the Federal Sustainable Development Strategy and have certain accountabilities around that. Secondly, we manage the environmental petitions process that I know some of you are familiar with, which is a nifty little process whereby any Canadian can write a letter to the Auditor General or to the Commissioner with questions for ministers, federal ministers, and we forward those on and they get responses within 120 days. And we report on that to Parliament as well. But what we really spend a lot of our time doing is performance audits. So we audit many different kinds of federal programs. We've done a lot of work on climate change and energy, invasive species. We do a lot of different kinds of environment and sustainable development performance audits. And really in those, we're looking at government has made commitments to Canadians, and we look to see whether government is doing what it said it would do. So that's really our role in performance audits. So the next thing I want to talk to you about is how we've integrated the SDGs into our office, because we're quite proud of this. And we've done this really, there's two stems from two reasons. First of all, in 2016, all auditors general from around the world met, as they do every 3 years, to talk about matters of strategic importance. And they identified the Sustainable Development Goals as something that all auditors general around the world we're very interested in and have a role to help measure, monitor, and verify progress towards the SDGs. So that was a big strategic decision. And Canada is doing that along with many other countries around the world. The second thing is we have a sustainable development strategy as well within our own office, and that is where we have said and committed to integrating the SDGs in our work. And when I say in our work, it's not just in the environment and sustainable development audits that we do, but it's in all of our audits. So if we're looking at defense, or we're looking at immigration, or we're looking at health, we consider the SDGs because they do really apply so broadly, and we consider those in all of the work that we do. So in the time I have left, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about our 2018 audit, where we looked at, we considered whether the government was prepared to implement the Sustainable Development Goals, and then Elsa's going to talk to you a bit about the current work that we're doing. So in 2018, the work would have started in 2017 or so, we conducted an audit which asked the question, is the government prepared to implement the Sustainable Development Goals? And you can see in the diagram here, we looked at seven things. And these seven things, we included seven different departments in the audit as well. And we found that the government is quite strong on commitment and responsibility towards the SDGs. And Stats Canada had made some very good progress looking at measuring, monitoring, and reporting on the global indicators. But really, items 2, 3, and 4 were really not in place. So, there wasn't no leader established. There wasn't really a governance system. There was no real engagement and consultation process established. And the implementation planning was really not there yet. So the conclusion of the audit was that the government was not prepared. Very happy to report, and as you know, in budget 2018, there was some money identified. This was subsequent to the publication of our audit. There was money identified to create the SDG unit, which is in the SDCs, we know, and has done some excellent work to move everything forward. On the next slide, I'll just point out that this work was important for what we're doing in Canada, but it's also important for other countries. So about 100 other countries in the world conducted a similar type of preparedness audit in a similar kind of way. And we identified many challenges and opportunities for governments and for audit offices. I'll basically just point out that there were three key barriers in summary to the successful implementation of SDGs that were found in these audits. The first one being policy coherence and how we integrate economic, social, and environmental matters and policy decisions, always a key element. How do we link the SDGs to the budgets? Very important and really, at the beginning phases throughout the world. And also data. We know the data is a big challenge for many countries, and no country is able to have all the information it needs to measure all of the SDGs at this point. And we reported this information to the High Level Political Forum in 2019. And we've learned lessons for future audits, and governments around the world are learning lessons as well. So I will turn it over to Elsa to talk to you about our current work.
Merci beaucoup, Kim. Mon nom, c'est Elsa D'Acosta et je suis directrice au Bureau du vérificateur général. Je vais vous parler de notre prochain outil qui est sur la mise en œuvre des ODD. Cet outil va regarder plusieurs aspects, mais on va essayer d'évaluer le progrès de la mise en œuvre nationale du programme 2030 et des ODD. On va essayer de regarder le progrès sur les recommandations qu'on avait en 2018 dans notre rapport. On va aussi regarder certains aspects qui ont été soulevés sous le travail d'INTOSAI, incluant les cohérences des politiques, liens avec des budgets et les données. On va aussi regarder certaines cibles qui se retrouvent sous trois des ODD. La prochaine diapo. La responsabilisation est essentielle pour les ODD. On trouve ça important pour nous et au BVG surtout. Donc, on a trois grandes questions qu'on se pose, nous, et on aimerait beaucoup entendre parler de vous et de votre rétroaction. Nos grandes questions, c'est est-ce que le gouvernement fédéral fait des progrès quant à ses engagements de mise en œuvre du programme 2030? Et on se demande pour les gouvernements, est-ce qu'ils collaborent ensemble à tous les niveaux et avec les communautés autochtones? Et les Canadiens, pour les Canadiens et la société civile, comment maintenir l'élan sous les paliers et favoriser la responsabilité des gouvernements pour les Canadiens? On aimerait beaucoup entendre parler de vous, donc je vous invite de communiquer avec moi à mon courriel ci-bas pour en discuter davantage de vos idées, vos commentaires et peut-être des réponses à certaines de nos questions. Merci beaucoup.
Merci à tous, merci beaucoup à tous ceux qui ont participé, qui ont contribué à la cérémonie d'ouverture. C'était vraiment de belles paroles et de beaux discours. Nous sommes sur le point de commencer le prochain bloc de programmation. N'oubliez pas, vous pouvez utiliser le hashtag sur toutes vos publications dans les médias sociaux, donc hashtag TogetherEnsemble2020 sur vos comptes sociaux. Remember, you can use the hashtags on all your social media posts with hashtag TogetherEnsemble2020 to your social accounts. Up next, you have the choice to of any of the following panels. After the pandemic, building back better in the United Nations Decade of Action, data, what is it good for, moral courage and the spirit, bear plan, Pandora's box, climate change as a threat multiplier. Please check the conference schedule for the corresponding Zoom links. Oui, il est temps pour nous de prendre place. Il est temps pour moi de prendre place à l'arrière du camion. Et on se verra encore à 13 heures, heure avancée de l'Est, lorsque vous rencontrerez le rapporteur principal, Jake Berkowitz, et son équipe. Enjoy all the viewing parties. Thank you.